Howdy. I wasn't even gonna stream today because it's a day that I work, and I almost never stream on days that I work. But I'm awake, and I thought I'm not going to work for a little while, so I will play some TF2. And I thought, well, if I'm gonna play TF2, I might as well stream it. So that's what I'm doing. So, let me find a server to join. Seems gonna keep refreshing the thing until I find a good one. Let's see, come on, there's gotta be something. Guess while I wait for this, oh, never mind. I was about to say while we wait, but I already found something. Cool. Epic. Epic meal time. Oof. Sorry if there's background noise. My family is home. But I think the noise filter should get most of the background noise. Oh, I forgot to do my stream config. Thanks, Pally. Well, that sucked. Off to a good start. Wait, where does our teleporter go to? That person's name is Trans Rights.
We got him, we got him.
Good username. All trying for sex. All right then. He did way more damage than I thought he would. Ugh. I feel like my mic is too close to my face.
Doc, come on, man. Yeah, thanks.
Got this scattergun skin from oh fuck. Oh, I feel like an asshole now. I don't remember who gifted it to me. Is it Kendra? I don't remember who gave it to me. Well, I think it was either Kendra or Heavy Thunder. I think. Alright, well, that was my mistake. Gato. Oh, he's got the urethra effect. He's gonna do some sneaking.
Thanks for that, tough guy.
Thanks for that, fucker. Okay. No, I'm sorry, Gato. I let that scout know the teleporter was there. I feel so bad about that. He spent all that time building that sentry and that teleporter, and I fucked it. The car has fucked! Oh, they have a sentry. Are you real? You're real. God damn it. I don't even think he knew I was there. I don't even think that Dylan knew I was there. I think he just detonated those at a convenient time. Shit. Yeah, I've considered putting on music in the background of my streams. Like nothing like the stuff I play at the beginning of the stream, because that's usually just a song I like. And while I'm playing, I would rather have something more chill. It's just some instrumental hip hop or something, but I don't know many good I don't have that many, like, albums in my library that would be good for that. Because I don't stream my music, I download it. So I would need to, like, specifically download music for that. None of the, most of the stuff I put on is, like, ambient music isn't really good background stuff, but... Maybe I could get it to work at some point. Right, this time I'm not. Help. Oh yeah, I forgot my username was Harry S. Plinkett. I was using an alias last night and I like completely forgot to change it back. Oh well.
Wait a minute. Rubbing that in a bit.
Okay. You're not real. All right, getting out of there. I'll do a sniper. I turn off my view models because it makes me look cool. Makes me look like I'm a competitive player. What the fuck? Oh. I don't know, that wasn't a headshot, but... Oh shit! Fucking sentry, you can't see it. Fuck you, Rusty. I shot that guy through my teammate. That, I'm proud of myself for that. Fuck. Jumped at a very inopportune time. I haven't played on Thunder Mountain in a long time. I'll wait for that. I actually can't remember the last time I played Thunder Mountain. Fuck. Yeah, move. Hi, King. Welcome. Nah, I'm playing on a community server. I literally haven't played on a Valve server in I think like 3 years. No, oh, man, you gotta stick with the line. Come on. Oh, I'm dead. Gunsnip. I haven't used this thing in a long time. I should just sell this thing. I never use it. You're getting a new PC? Nice. Yeah. Whoops. I need to do that. move these things up. One sec. Hang on a sec. Was checking something. Oh, your motherboard died? That sucks. I'm glad you're building a new one, though. Fuck. I'm so bad. He's dead. I'm getting a 4070 Ti. Nice. Getting a lot of good stuff for that thing. My mom is nearing the checkpoint! I feel like this is what you call a steamroll. Vote to scramble. That was way too quick. No, don't RTV. This map's awesome. Sorry, I'm looking at something real quick. Need a dispenser here. Need it.
Mission begins in 10 seconds.
Alright then. I didn't realize I had a crit. Super. Rip. Shit. Shit, fuck. Don't worry, I'll defend you while you're taunting. Didn't know I had a job. Yeah, I'm a pizza delivery driver. It's not too bad. I mean, it's a minimum wage paying job in America, so it's bad. But for a minimum wage job, it's not bad. We scramble the teams. Can we do that, maybe? Unpopular opinion, but I don't like steamrolls. Don't argue, just scramble. Like, people for some reason just never want to scramble in this fucking game, ever. It's like taboo to scramble the fucking beams. Team scramble you? I don't know what that means, Laney.
The cards just appreciate it.
Spirit of Halloween metagun, I forgot that was a thing. Bye. Femboy Ventily.
Thanks, mate.
Holy shit, they got John Dungus in this server.
The cart ain't moving, legs.
Who's shooting? You real? You're real. Tits. Ah, tits.
The bomb ain't moving.
Cool toy you got there. Doing much. Fuck. Yeah, put that frying pan handle in your mouth. What the fuck? Why is there a soccer ball? The hell? Chalery. It's a fun way to spell my name. Good night, King. Good night, King. Sounds like I'm like complimenting you. Like when people on Twitter call someone a king. Yeah, good night. Have a good one. It's an interesting ragdoll. Shit! Sorry.
They're all a bunch of now hopers.
Fuck. What's getting up here? Is he?
Victory.
Fucking scramble. People have garbage opinions on the maps in this game. Thunder Mountain's a fucking dope map.
Mission begins in 30 seconds.
TV to Hydro. I'm gonna nominate Viaduct because I like that map. If it does RTV, I'll be happy with Viaduct, but I don't want it to RTV. You have garbage opinions in this game. Sorry about the background noise. Stuff going on in the hallway. Go, guys. Go, gamers. Go, gamer. Wow, I'm on fire. Who's pinging me on this board?
What? What you want?
There are people in my room. My mom and sister just came into my room. Not even to talk to me. They just came in while they were talking to each other. So I don't know what that was about. And also I clicked on OBS and changed my mic gain because I was frantically trying to mute myself while they were talking. So I hope I'm not too loud now. I don't remember what it was at before. I think that's it. I think that's the right game. Fuck. There we go. I don't even know what happened here. Good job. Whoa, bye! You're a spy! Physics so much. One of the greatest inventions in video gaming. Fuck. Get me the fuck out of here! Yeah, that's right. Run. Don't run, it's just ham. Let's go this way. B. God damn it, the fucking gate. Come on. Oh, you pussy. Come on. I see that dot. Woo! He charged that like the perfect amount. Oh my god, I'm bad. So scared to like actually go out this gate because I'm gonna die the second I do. God. Are people gonna fucking scramble now? Like, now that the map is almost over, is now the point where it's gonna scramble? Because I'll never understand people in this fucking game. Thanks. What? Who's that?
Bing Jiling.
What?
Bing Jiling.
Bing Jiling? I don't know what you're saying. He pulled my foreskin back.
He pulled it back?
I have not stopped thinking about that. I might honestly watch that video again at work today.
It was the day on Halloween where the man ran in and he funny screamed.
Well, I killed him.
Oh!
Oh, god damn it. Where did funny scream originate? Because I know he says, like, what if a man run in and he funny scream? What series was that?
That's a good question. I don't know.
Because the Yoshi's Dead and Loving It wasn't the origin. I think that was, like, a callback.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess
they called it back in another thing. Trivia from our Let's Play. What did the man run in and do?
I could probably just Google it. Like, what episode it's from. Why are there soccer balls in the game? What is this for? I don't ever remember seeing this on this map before.
Mission begins in 60 seconds.
People are leaving because they're pussies and don't like this map.
It's Team Fortress.
Team Gortress. I'm thinking of streaming Dwarf Fortress at some point because I've been playing it recently. But it's a very hard game to learn, and I like just started playing, so I'm terrible at it, but I think it'd be fun to stream it.
What is
the point of this? Dwarf Fortress 2? The ball is from a cosmetic or a cosmetic combo of the scout. Oh. So what, there's like a scout...
I love my ball!
What, there's a scout set where if you wear it, it just spawns a soccer ball in your team's spawn room or something?
Mission begins in 10 seconds.
That's neat.
I would get on and play TF2 now, but I need to finish up one thing and I'm struggling with it.
My username is still Harry S. Plinkett from when I was playing last night, and I forgot that I turned on an alias. That was scary. Thank you, Jenna. Oh, I'm doing bad. Just, Ashley, kill someone, please. Okay. Scout football hooliganism moments.
So true.
I guess I'll try scout. I can't believe people are saying that Thunder Mountain sucks on this server. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Oh, I thought they meant the Disney ride.
No, that's... Isn't that Space Mountain? I don't think
no,
there's
they have
a Disney...
Thunder Mountain Railroad as well.
Oh, well, that's actually really funny. I never thought about that. Official TF2 ride at Disney. Oh, I'm so bad. Oh, come on. I just had to reload once. He has 30 health. Pencil champion.
Fasten your seatbelt, soldier. Keep your arms, legs, and fucking weapons inside the vehicle at all times.
Egon's Spirit Melter. That's a good username. Yeah, I was going to say, I know they have multiple mountain rides, but I didn't know they had that. Oh, Spy.
They are doing away with Splash Mountain soon. They're replacing it. They're replacing it with Princess and the Frog.
They're replacing it with Racism Mountain.
No, everyone's, it was Racism Mountain. That's the problem.
Everyone's favorite ride. Really? Was Splash Mountain racist?
No, it just had characters from Song of the South.
Oh, I don't remember. I don't think I've ever been on it. I think
I don't know.
I thought it was just a water ride. I didn't realize it had any kind of theming with characters.
To me, they are just Splash Mountain characters because Song of the South is more boring than it is racist.
You've seen it?
A little bit. Turned it off because I was bored.
Reminds me of there's an Ed Ake video where he's talking about what was he talking about? There's an Ed Ake video essay about something Disney related, and like he's like mentioning Disney movies, and the when he mentions Song of the South, the way he phrased it, like really really quietly, he's like the one with the slaves. Just really quietly.
No, there wasn't anything inherently racist on there, which kinda isn't justified, but like it has characters from Song of the South, which is, you know.
You're gonna die!
No, I'm not.
I am Chris O'Neill.
I'm Chris O'Neill!
You're the spy!
We got him. It's Ake!
I just saved your life, Sniper. Master Among Rust. That guy's name is Refeart. I'm assuming it's Riphart, but because the P and the H are together, I'm gonna pronounce it Refeart. What if JFK's last word before his head got blown off was "Gotta blast"? Or what if he just said "brain blast" and then he got shot? Brain blast! Just explodes. Ah, I'm so bad!
His full name was like John Fortnite Kennedy.
Yeah. Now see, that joke is overdone, so now it's actually funnier to pick a different word that starts with F. His name is John Fazbear Kennedy.
John Flansburg.
What the hell? I've never thought about it. What the hell does Fazbear mean? Freddy Fazbear. What, that name means nothing.
No, it literally doesn't.
If it was like Fezbear and he wore a fez, that'd be something. But he wears a top hat. Like, what is a Fazbear?
A bear of fez.
Like, why isn't it just Fred Bear is a Five Nights at Freddy's character. There is a character named Fred Bear. So why isn't that just his name? He had to have had a one-liner because his head just did that, yeah.
Yeah, he knew he was gonna just do that.
JFK was a sufferer of terminal head explosion disease. It's a disease where you don't know when it will happen.
Poor John Flansburg Kennedy.
You don't know when it will happen. It's just like it eventually your head will explode at some point. And you're given like maybe 10 seconds of like you know it's gonna happen before it happens, but only 10 seconds. Medic!
John Flansburg Kennedy.
My favorite member of They Might Be Giants. Man, I haven't played Scout in a while, and I feel like turning off my view models is actually making me get meat shots better.
I wish Rodney Greenblatt threw JFK's motorcade car into the parade in the first album's cover.
What was his name?
Rodney Greenblatt.
Every time I hear Greenblatt, I just think of the guy who created Chowder and Harvey Beats.
Rodney Greenblatt's the guy who made Parappa, and also he did the album cover for the first They Might Be Giants album.
If he was Dib's sibling, he would be Freddy Gazbear. I was watching Invader Zim with some friends recently. It's still funny. Very gross. It's a very gross show, but I think in a charming way. Like, it doesn't treat kids like they're idiots. It's a kid's show, but it ventures into some very dark stuff, like people having their organs stolen. And I'm pretty sure, like, some character, like, one character straight up gets his eyeballs ripped out and permanently replaced by, like, robotic ones. And he's screaming in pain while it happens.
I was able to relate to that scene. I've had an organ stolen.
I thought you were gonna say I've had an orgasm, and I was like, I don't know how that relates, but good for you.
You stole my heart, remember?
Oh, shut up. Oh my god, I'm so fucking stupid.
Jump the fucking wall.
By Pink Floyd.
Oh.
God fucking tits.
I found this thing recently where Dark Side of the Moon is celebrating its 50th anniversary and
People are getting mad that there's a rainbow logo on it. Yeah. On the album that has a white spectrum on the cover. I will never listen to this band again. Medic, you have a weapon. Fight back. Retaliate. Come on, do something. Okay. I almost feel bad for doing that.
You just fucking clipped him.
Are you watching the stream?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so bad.
A little behind, like most of the streams.
I got work and the stream will probably end in like an hour and 10 minutes because that's when I gotta get ready for work. You're not real!
I have a very early cut tomorrow. I gotta set the alarm. We're going at 7:45.
Kill the medic! My winger ranked up because I'm actually playing scout for once. What the fuck?
Wait,
what's happening?
I didn't mean to do that snort so hard. What the fuck?
Brother just came over to. Sorry, I hadn't said anything for a minute. My brother was in my room, like, watching me play over my shoulder. Iggy, no!
Tell your brother there's no backseat gaming allowed.
He wasn't even backseat gaming, he was just silently watching me play. It was creepy in a way. Someone trying to do rock, paper, scissors. Why do I hear someone saying, "Give us a throw"?
Do they want to be thrown?
I'm a chuckster. I've never played Mario Sunshine, but I've heard that level is fucking miserable.
There are a lot of janky, miserable levels.
Yeah, I've just heard that Mario 64 is just hard. It's just that it got that, like, old Mario game difficulty.
No, there are some that are just blatantly fucking janky.
Oh, like the lily pad one. Isn't that one just stupid?
And the pachinko one. And the chuckster one, like, things.
Doesn't the lily pad, like, move in the direction you shoot instead of the opposite of the direction you shoot, which is how it would actually work with real physics?
I'm not quite sure. It's been a while.
Daigoom left the game. I remember when I played Scout TF2. I never played Scout. I only play, like, Sniper and Soldier regularly, and I've been trying to fix that recently. I've been trying to branch out.
I remember my first Krabby Patty.
Everyone remembers their first Krabby Patty. You like Krabby Patties, don't you, Squidward?
Nuh-uh. Why is nuh-uh so funny to me?
Is it?
That was like the meme of like a fucking like Scarlet Witch with Thanos. You took everything from me! Nuh-uh.
As someone who is 100% in Mario Sunshine and loves that game, it sucks and is an unfinished and unpolished game. Fair enough, Laney.
It had good intentions. It gave us Bowser Jr., who was a funny little lad.
A what?
A funny little lad.
I thought you said horny, and I was like, what the fuck are you- Well, I don't know, Like, you were muffled by sounds coming from the game, so I just heard I just heard me, and- So I don't know, I just thought you said holy
little
lad. No,
he is a pleasant little lad.
Mama Luigi!
Now I know how a meatball feels!
Thinking about that Futurama YTP, the brained one.
Oh yeah.
The big. Again, and.
Hey, Ashley.
Shoutouts to Pedge on YouTube, P-E-J. They don't upload anymore, but they made really good, like, surrealist white YouTube hoops.
Hey, Ashley.
Yeah.
Brought to you by Bounty.
Yeah.
I fucking love that one. YTP the Muppet 4.
Sucks. Didn't even warrant being put into my important YTP's playlist.
Fuck!
Fuck. Get him, PK Beast. But yeah, if you like stupid, surreal, avant-garde YTPs, check out Pedge, P-E-J, on YouTube. Specifically, they have a video just called P, like the letter P, and they have a video called Super, and they are both amazing. And the one I was just referencing is called Brained, B-R-A-I-N-D. All three of those are very good videos. Gabinator. What was the next map? Here, I didn't even vote. I forgot to look. Too busy trying to kill people.
That happens.
Those Latin Redoc! Come on! Alright, you wankers! Shuck on my penis. I think penis is a funnier word if you make the S into an SH. Excuse me, you have an exquisite penis. Has anyone ever called your penis exquisite before, Dennis?
What was that?
Has anyone ever called your penis exquisite before?
No.
Unfortunate. Let's do this Texas toast. Yeah, you do it.
Hey, fellers.
What the fuck?
Do Wonderwall!
Yick.
Shit. I like the one where it's a fucking cartoon Mario sentence mix to say that.
What the fuck?
Mario squared?
I like the Tumblr post. Someone posted, like, if you ever want to make a really good sentence mix for fucking, just take the word fine-looking and, like, cut out the middle. And someone demonstrated it with a scene from SpongeBob from the pizza delivery episode, and Skipper was just like, sure is a fucking pizza.
Sure is a fucking pizza.
Yeah, he doesn't even say it like he's emphasizing it. He's just, sure is a fucking pizza. Like, he makes it sound like fucking is an adjective modifying pizza. Like, what's a fucking pizza? It's a pizza you eat specifically before having sex. You do not eat it at any other time.
I will not question why.
Oh, I got a loose fingernail. It's not a hangnail or anything. I'm sorry, I just started laughing. One of my medic has a fucking medigun just called torture device. Oh, that got me. I couldn't even focus on reflecting those rockets. That's such a good medigun name. Just torture device. Would I eat a pizza that's had more sex than I have? What, like, did someone come on it? Is it like that?
Oh no, I'm thinking of a video. Oh no.
The Ninja Turtles one?
Yeah.
What's that video called again?
I think it's like Pizza Time or something.
Yeah, it's just called Pizza Time. That's a classic of disgusting internet videos.
Watermelon.
Yeah, I've seen that video. I like how you were like, oh, I'm thinking of something bad, and I immediately knew what you were thinking of because I was thinking of it too. Don't look up a video just called Pizza Time on Google.
They're doing it right now, Ashley.
It's not good. Like, I know you're thinking, well, you telling me not to look it up. Like, no, I have to. Like, trust me, it's not good.
Sergeant Soppy does not like that video.
I'm just going to describe it, so if you are curious, I can dissuade you from looking it up. It is four guys dressed up like the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles jacking off onto a pizza. It's horrible. Don't look it up. Unless you're into that sort of thing, I guess. Kill the medic!
No, it gets weird quick. There's more than that. But
I don't actually remember what comes I honestly don't remember what comes after that, and I'd prefer to keep it that way. Don't remind me whatever it is.
I don't remember all of it either, honestly, but I remember something else happened.
Well, you don't use the fists of steel in a melee fight. I don't know if that's the case. I just know they're jerking off on a pizza. Come here.
This is not TOS.
Hi. Just following this guy. This map isn't very good for pyro because there's water everywhere. God, I'll never forget about the night I got my strain sticky bomb launcher and just named it Stinky Bomb Launcher. With the description, alt fire, detonate all stinky bombs. It's fucking stupid.
Were you just giggling to yourself the whole time?
Pretty much. Hey, you're not real.
That's what you sound like.
It's not what I sound like when I giggle. I don't really giggle. I like full on laugh, or I just like don't really do anything. Get away from me!
Ew, yucky, stinky bomb, pee, ew.
God damn it.
Thank you, Sergeant Soppy.
This map's not good for pyro because there's water everywhere. Pyro Shark. Well, like, Pyro Shark is like a joke loadout. It's not good if you want to, like, actually play pyro that can roam the map. If you're a pyro shark, you basically have to stick in water or near water. And the whole map isn't water. I'm just saying, like, people can extinguish themselves easily if you set them on fire. You gotta kill them quick.
Just drink all the water. Aren't you parched?
You're not fucking pushing that cart onto that point. I swear to God. Fucking damn it. Joke loadout survival if you dedicate 100% of your playtime to one of them. Yeah, but I don't do that. I play Trolljer a lot, but I don't dedicate all of my time to it. I just think it's a fun loadout to do. Let's play some fucking heavy. Come back to little cunt! I'm so fucking slow. He's gonna come up here.
Medic,
what are you hoping to accomplish there, dude? What was your plan there? Hello. Fuck off, Pyro. I got an achievement. Holy shit. Can't remember the last time that happened. What did the heavy just say? Did he say what simp? What simp? Nice sentry gun, idiot.
Oh, what took you so long?
I have a 10 kill streak. What the fuck? Hey, what are you shooting at?
Ah, boom.
What are you guys shooting at? I'm gonna die, but I don't even care. I'm just fucking mowing people down. I don't even care, dude. I just got a 13 kill streak in my first life is heavy. Kill 50 enemies within 3 seconds of them attacking your medic. I guess I just don't play heavy enough to have gotten that achievement before.
I remember I went into this weird server and got a bunch of achievements at once.
Yeah, that was an idle server. Do you remember the SpongeBob episode Wet Painters?
Of course.
I don't know what it was actually called, but I remember there was a really old SpongeBob YTP I used to love when I was like 13 that was where the title card was edited to say Wet Strippers. And I think that's a really good joke. A really good edit to just imagine a SpongeBob episode called Wet Strippers. You know what? I'm gonna quit the Carl loadout because I think it's funny. Aqua Teen Schlunger Force. Aquaflops. I should buy an unusual Carl if those exist, just because it's a funny loadout to have.
Those freaking Aqua Teens!
I need to watch Aqua Teen Hunger Force sometime. It's on my list of shows to get to.
It doesn't freaking matter. None of this matters.
I've always really loved the whole thing that they live in Seattle, New Jersey. Like, that's the name of the town.
I forgot about that.
That's where the show comes from.
I haven't watched a lot, but I liked what I watched. Also, I watched the movie before the show.
Aqua Teen something whatever. How much money do I have into the game? I mean, it's hard to keep track of that specifically, just because I've played it for so long. I've bought several unusuals and a lot of strange weapons, so at least, like, several $100s, but that's spread out over the course of, like, a decade. It's not, like, all at once. I don't actually know the... What?
If I had a dollar for every adult cartoon that I've seen the movie of before the actual show, I'd have $2.
What's the other one?
The other two are Bob's Burgers and, believe it or not, Simpsons.
Wouldn't it be three, then?
No, I said three.
You said two.
I said two?
Maybe I just misheard you, but I thought you said two. What was the third one? I heard Bob's Burgers and...
Believe it or not, The Simpsons.
Oh. Well, no, the Carl's a full cosmetic. Like, it has the hair on it. I'll look up if an unusual the Carl exists.
By the way, the Bob's Burgers movie is fucking great.
Damn it! There aren't unusual ones. That sucks.
Yeah, I need an unusual mustache and receding hairline.
I think it'd be funny to get, like, the sunshine effect, so it just looks like his head is shiny from being bald.
Bald!
Bald! Bald! Bald! Bald! My eyes! My leg! Hey! I'm getting double-teamed by French people. That came out wrong. Okay, I didn't realize their entire team was around that corner.
Oh, you know.
Hot Russian stud gets double-teamed by French twinks. Oh my god! Their head.
Let's stop that freaking thing! Oh, I just saw that.
Let's stop that fucking thing! I've had this conversation with my friends a few times, but it's weird that Valve has, like, a policy of not putting the word fuck into their games even when they're rated M. Like, they'll say shit, they'll say ass, they'll say damn it. They literally just don't like the word fuck in their games. Like, it's like a weird that's not a law of, like, game censorship. Like, you know, GTA is rated M. It's not like you get an AO if your game says fuck. They just don't do it. Half-Life 2 does technically have Half-Life 2 does technically have a fuck in it, but the line is scripted so that when it plays, the fuck gets super quiet. Because the joke is, like, while he's saying it, because Barney says that. There's a line and a half or two where Barney says, and if you see Dr. Breen, tell him I said, fuck you. But when he says, fuck you, there's like the sound of rubble crashing. So the joke is that he's like censored. And you can't hear it uncensored in the game files, but it literally makes the line quieter when he says it in game. So I don't think that counts. You have to go into the files to really hear it clearly.
It reminds me, in Spyro Reignited Trilogy, there's a part where the word ass is cut off, but they still animated Spyro's mouth to say it.
I like that one meme screenshot that goes around where it's just fat Spyro.
I'm so full from cigarettes! Yum.
Like, I don't know the con- I've never played a Spyro game. Actually, no,
That's
played-
a mod.
Oh. I thought that was, like, just something that happens on them. Well, yeah, I think that's a very funny screenshot. Are Spyro and Skylanders at all related?
Spyro was in Skylanders.
Okay, because I remember when I was a kid, I had a neighbor who had Skylanders, and I played that, and I seem to remember there being some connection, but I've never played a Spyro game.
Spyro,
I don't even know what
Cinder
genre they are,
playable.
Other than platformer. Is it like Banjo-Kazooie? Is it like a collectathon platformer?
What? With combat.
Hmm. Yeah.
Oh, woo! Not to mention, in the final Skylanders game, Crash and Cortex were put in.
If Banjo and Goofy had a baby, it would go Gyuh.
It'd be awesome.
I try to combine Goofy's noise and Banjo's noise.
Like in Diddy Kong Racing, Banjo goes, I'm Banjo! Oh!
I like in Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts when Tyler, the Creator, is in it. Did you see that on the stream? Guy tried to use his flog. Didn't work. Whoa! Shot put. He cratered. Oh, no, he didn't. I thought he cratered. Yo, what's up? Yo, what's up? Yo, what's up? Puppy girl. Good username. Ah!
Identity theft is not a joke, Ashley. Stole your identity.
Skylanders is part of the Spyro lore. Okay.
Yeah, because Spyro and Cinder are both in the first game, at least.
Spyro goes to Taco Bell. Spyro
Subway.
Goes to Subway. Oh, I hate myself for bringing that up. That's another thing to not look up. Spyro at Subway. Don't look that up. If you're on the internet, I'd honestly be surprised if you didn't already know what that is. But don't. If you don't know what it is, keep it that way. Is this engineer currently repairing this teleporter? Because I can't destroy it. What the fuck? Joe's child. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Welcome to
subbing
to
on
the
your
sub
first
club.
Time at on the stream. Thank you. I don't know how you found the channel, but I appreciate it. I honestly always forget that I made a custom MIDI thing for people subscribing, and then I hear it, and I'm like, oh, what the fuck?
Paul?
I made custom MIDI files, like...
No, that's just your reaction, like, Paul.
No, I was just saying, like, for people in chat who don't know, like, that was it. I composed that. I just composed, like, three little guitar solo rock things as MIDI files for follow and sub notifications.
MIDI ditties.
If I made, like, an entire album of songs that were composed as MIDI files, that's what I would call it. Which I have thought about doing in the past. That Spy was really smart. Shout out to that guy. Shout out to the simple pimple. Why is this teleporter invincible? Is the engineer just sitting there whacking it with his wrench nonstop?
Oh, you know.
What the fuck is going on? What the
oh, I don't know.
Fuck is going on here? Cuban Missile Crisis.
Cuban Missile Crisis!
There's a cosmetic in TF2 called the Cuban Bristle Crisis, and every time I see someone wearing it and read the name, I just think of that. Chowder, look at what you've done! Now the animators are gonna have to draw all this fire. That's the other side of the teleporter. There's four engineers hitting it at all times. I mean, that's what it feels like. Both times I went there, like several minutes apart, and I tried to destroy it, there was still, it was not dying. And I definitely did enough damage to destroy it. Why is that the only thing I remember from Chowder? It's not. That's just my favorite line from Chowder. Like, of all the fourth wall... I don't know. I can't explain it, like, because Chowder has lots of fourth wall brain jokes. I can't explain why that one's my favorite, but it just is.
The car wash.
That one I really love. That's probably my second favorite. No money means no animation. Yes, because it's a good bit, Lainey. It's my favorite bit from Chowder. I think it's just the exasperation in his voice, like he genuinely feels bad for the animators. I think that might be it. I don't know. I can't explain it. It's just, I love that joke from Chowder. It's my favorite.
Oh, Ashley, you should check out the show, what was it? Jellystone?
Oh yeah, that's by C.H. Greenblatt, isn't it?
Yeah. A lot of the same humor.
I was actually just looking him up recently. Like, just to see what he's been up to other than Chowder, because I actually didn't know much about him, so I was curious. Finally, the fucking teleporter's dead. Broke his stupid crab, moron. Let's go sneak up on them. I'm so sneaky. I don't think they can go out that way. You're a teleporter. Let's go. Yeah, that's what you get.
You're getting dominated, Chucklehead.
That's what you get for trying to kill me. Edgar, please leave me alone. Someone's just actually pleading in the chat. I got sandwiched. I got stuck between a pyro and a bullet place.
Heavy would like to know your location.
What?
Heavy would like to know your location.
Yeah.
You got sandwiched.
I want to edit the game files so anytime, because there's the Carbonado strange weapons, which is like a type of bot killer one from MVM. And I want to change it so it just says Carbonara. Like it's just made out of pasta.
Also the name of that hidden camera. Magic TV show.
Well, that's Michael Carbonaro. That's Michael Carbonaro. I actually used to watch that show.
I've seen him live, by the way.
He's gay.
True!
This game looks so weird without the gun taking up half the screen. I normally have U models on. I'm just, I don't know. Some reason today I felt like turning them off.
What the fuck? Michael Carbonaro is 46 years old? He doesn't look it.
Yeah. It's like 76 years old. Fuck. What? There we go. Joke's on you, I destroyed the teleporter.
And now we're doing it, now we're doing it.
You cretin, you leave my teleporter alone. Oh, I'm gonna die. God damn it. Two people got revenge on me once.
Cosmo Wanda, I wish everyone's TF2 default settings would turn back on out of nowhere.
I'll never forget one of my favorite Tumblr posts. Just says, Timmy Turner voice. I wish that everybody who dies goes to hell no matter what.
Hell no matter what.
And there's a follow-up to it where someone said, I thought about this post earlier and nearly fell down the stairs.
But,
every time
well,
I think
Timmy,
of it,
it's against the rules.
I mean, not, like, no, it's funnier if you just don't follow up on it at all, because, like, it's just like, what the hell is wrong with him that a 10-year-old would wish for this? It's just funny thinking about it logistically. Like, what the hell is his problem?
Vicky just fucked him up that bad.
It's also the way he says it. It's also the way it's phrased. It's not like, Like, it's not just, like, I wish that everybody gets sent to hell when they die. No, it's I wish that everybody who dies goes to hell no matter what. It's just a mix of the phrasing and... Oh, it's so good. I also like the way they make you think of Timmy Turner. They just say Timmy Turner voice. It's not like Timmy Turner, colon. It's Timmy Turner voice.
How much do I have to pay Tara Strong to say it?
God, does she have cameo?
No.
God, if Carolyn Lawrence had a cameo, I would definitely pay her to say something in Oral's voice.
She has a Discord server now.
Carolyn Lawrence has a Discord server?
Yes.
For, like, just for fans of her? Or is she like a Twitch streamer or something?
I think it's kind of like following up on the same hype that Mark DiCarlo got, where he made one.
I didn't know that. I like that Mark Hoppus, bass player and vocalist for acclaimed pop punk band Blink-182, is just a Twitch streamer now, like in his late 40s, early 50s, however old he is. Like, he's just this guy who's been in a rock band since, like, the early 90s, and now he's just, like, he plays video games on Twitch.tv. Like, it's just funny to me to think about, like, I wonder if how many people out there had no idea what Blink-182 was, but they're like, oh, I love Mark Hoppus, he's my favorite streamer. It's like, oh, have you ever listened to Blink? Have I ever listened to what? Like, they're completely unaware. I doubt that there's anyone like that, because his server advertises it, that he's like a member of that band. But it's just funny to think, like, I wonder if anyone knows him just for being a streamer. It's like Vinny. Like, Vinny's said on a few occasions, like, he'll know that Redbox is a popular... like, hypothetically, he'll know if Redbox is a popular band someday, because then people will start to know him as the Redbox guy and not the Vine Sauce guy. Who is messaging me on Discord?
What? I was about to. I didn't send anything yet. I know this link looks fishy, but this leads to Karen Lawrence's Discord server if you want.
I just got a friend request from, like, one of my partners, but, like, I guess they made a new account that looks exactly the same as their old one.
They got locked out, or this is a scam?
Well, they've done it before. I'm not gonna say why, because it's a personal reason, but they've like, abandoned an account and made a new one before, so I'm wondering if it's the same thing, so I'm just gonna ask them and see what they say. But that did surprise...
It's okay, though.
No, they should be fine. I know the reason that they've done it before, and it's, like, bad, but nothing, like threatening. So they're probably okay. I killed Puppy Girl. I'm so sorry. Whoa, he's flying. Oh my god, I didn't think I would get that.
I'm clipping that.
Holy shit. I didn't think that I would actually hit that.
What should I title the clip?
I don't know. I ain't a fucking clipper. Did I just bump a spy? You're not real. In your language. Okay, they just said my account was obliterated by Discord. That's all they said, so I'm gonna ask for more information. So it's not the reason that they did it before. I'm actually surprised that that's... I'm gonna ask what they mean. I always forget that this map does fireworks whenever a point is captured. Oh shit.
Here, I clipped your awesomeness, Ashley.
You're not real, you're French!
No, I'm not.
I like that they made the spy the sneaky asshole that no one likes, because he's always cowardly and fights like a bitch. I like that they made him a French guy.
Ooh, yeah, you're...
just sitting there.
Oops, I minimized OBS.
Don't do that.
I mean, it's not like it's gonna break the stream, I just couldn't read chat.
Don't do that.
Hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing, Buster?
The mom!
Hey! Shit fuck.
Where do I put the...
The what?
The clip of you doing the really cool kill.
I mean, I don't know, just put it in chat if you want.
Oh, okay.
I don't really have, like, a place for it.
The chat allows URLs, right?
Yeah, which one specifically?
What was that noise, woman?
I was scared! I feared for my life! God damn it. Fucking penis.
Do you need a hug? Are you scared?
Good joke. Never watched Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared.
No, I actually wasn't trying to go for that. Wow.
Wow, really?
No.
That was such like a specific joke, I seriously, like, the fact that you accidentally did that is, I believe you, but it's almost, it's unbelievable.
Do you want the fucking hug or not?
You want the hug or are you scared? Peek your fucking head out, bitch.
Answer me already so I can pick the fuck at me and comfort you.
Sorry, puppy girl. It's nothing personal.
I like pickpocketing people.
I like pickpocketing people. Get the fuck off me!
Someone's gonna use this clip against me one day.
I like put-pocketing people, which is where you just dump stuff into people's pockets secretly without them noticing.
Put a couple dimes in there.
That was a good ragdoll. Oh god, they have crits!
I got shits.
I got the shits.
How did you know? It's those fucking Jacob the Loofah videos where stuff TF2 players say. I think it was his stuff that inspired me to voice act at first.
Critical shit.
God damn right, the fucking medic is medicating.
Let him do medicine. Anyway, that's how I lost my medicinal license. That's what he says, that's the line.
True.
Oh, good guy. Someone fucking poke their stupid head out so I can shoot it. I want to make a TF2 map that looks exactly like whatever the street is where JFK got shot on, and make it so you can only play sniper on it. What the fuck was that street called? Where was JFK assassinated?
Outside.
Thanks. Dealey Plaza. I knew it was in Dallas, Texas, but I was trying to remember the name of the street. It was in Dealey Plaza.
Thank you.
You know nothing bad ever happens to the Kennedys. Ah, nothing. Fucker. This stupid cracker.
We use the word cracker so much as a joke in another server that I can't believe this joke has finally crossed over to you.
It's not a joke, I just... Cracker's a funny word. It's funny to call white people crackers.
Like, it's a server that me, Corbin, and Clay are in, and, it's just been a big inside joke since the beginning of the year, and... Lo and behold, we started referring to a Mario Party map as Cracker Island, and then the Gorillaz album got announced.
Is that what the album... I didn't know a new album got announced. Is that what it's called?
Yes. Even though there were way two better names, like, mentioned in the lore.
He was never the same after he saw the Hat Man with the umbrella. Laney, I don't know what that's a reference to. Also, I can't...
Wait, do not know... Did you seriously not know about Cracker Island, Ashley?
What? No, yeah, I didn't. I didn't hear about that. I don't really keep up with, like, so Gorillaz news. I like them. But...
Check out the songs from this album so far. Four of them are out and they're good.
Some interesting death pose.
Wait, is that sniper doing, like, the downward dog?
A really extreme downward dog where you break your spine. I can't see that emote for some reason. Which is weird, because I have, like, Franker Face Z and stuff, so I don't know what's up with that. Just isn't showing in chat.
I like Spock.
Okay, I'm getting out of there. We have three snipers, so when I die, I'm probably gonna switch. Although, watch as I do that, and then the other two guys switch, so we have no snipers. He held an umbrella out right before JFK was killed. Why is that? Is that like a conspiracy theory that he had something to do with it?
I did.
People theorize he was connected to the assassination. Why? Oh, he had an umbrella. He did it. He's the killer. He was the one up on the grassy knoll. JFK was actually shot 8 times by 8 different people. Who were not collaborating together, there were just 8 people who all wanted him dead there at the same time. It's a crazy coincidence. One of my favorite SCP articles is about JFK's assassination, and it's basically that people keep time traveling back to try and prevent it, and the Foundation has to keep undoing the time travel to keep it from, like, to make sure it does happen. Not because, like, they need JFK to be dead, but because, like, it's considered messing with history, and even if they don't want someone killed, if it already happened in history, then they feel like it should have stayed that way. So the whole article is just multiple attempts of them to make sure JFK is killed by Lee Harvey Oswald. Specifically that, they not just that he's killed, they have to make sure that Lee Harvey Oswald is, like, the one who's blamed for killing him. People think the guy was given a signal. With no evidence, obviously. Touch it! Touch the cart!
Reach out and touch cart.
Good joke. Viaduct! Please vote for Viaduct. They're gonna vote for fucking Swiftwater.
Reach out and touch grass.
They're gonna vote for fucking Swiftwater because they're nerds and people only like to play 3 maps on these servers. Viaduct. 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 Don't vote for Mountain Lab. I'll kill you.
Okay, Ashley, hop on with me. We'll play 2 for it.
Viaduct. Viaduct. Okay, we're good. Oh, but like half the server's leaving. What's my favorite moment from this game? Oh man, I've been playing this game for so long. I don't even know if I like remember all the stuff that's happened. It's a good question. I don't know. I have to think about it. A lot of funny stuff has happened to me while playing this game. Just law of large numbers. If you play a game long enough, I'm sure something funny is bound to happen.
It's not hard, mate.
There's something funny.
Prepare to be peaked in 30 seconds.
No! No!
Pete from the Goofy movie.
No, I don't want to be Pete!
Rocket jump, baby. Damn it, if I had killed that guy, I would have been so happy. This is like one of my favorite maps to play Sniper on. Because it's just so tight. It's such a tight, fast-paced map that there's a lot of opportunities for cool headshots. Like this one. Fuck. I meant to say, like this one. Fuck. What the fuck? Thought I heard a decode behind me. Fuck your mini. One. Headshot. There we go.
I was about to warn you about something, but then I realized it was... you're on the blue team.
I heard that. I heard a decloak. I heard it. You fucker. Bitch. He got away. Good thing, too. You were this close to losing your jet. You know what that's a reference to, Dennis?
What was it?
He was referencing the shitty boss from The Incredibles. So I was saying that a scout cloaked and I was like, he got away. And I said, good thing too, you were this close to losing your jet.
Oh yeah.
When he, you know, when he throws him through like 15 walls.
I'm not happy, Bob. Not happy.
Not happy. Ask me why. Why what? Be specific, Bob. Why are you unhappy? Your customers make me unhappy. Like, that character sucks, obviously, but he's in the movie for such a short time, and he's funny, at least, because he's just such a shithead.
And he's voiced by Wallace Shawn, there's that.
Wallace Shawn is actually really cool. He's an awesome actor. He's got some cool politics. Speaking of Wallace Shawn, I need to watch my dinner with Andre sometime.
I need to watch The Princess Bride.
Oh yeah, I forgot he was in that. I've never seen either of those movies, and I've heard they're both really good. Cilantro. I don't think I've ever had cilantro in my life, so I don't know if I have the soap gene or not.
I'm pretty sure I don't.
I didn't realize there was a sniper there for half a second. I had to, like, process it. My computer has a half-core processor. Dog food lid. You watched My Dinner with Andre for a college assignment? I've heard it's a very good movie, and I want to watch it. Someone made an edit of it called, My Dinner with Kanye. And it's just Wallace Shawn talking, like, with out-of-context Kanye clips. It's pretty funny. I think this was pre-Nazi Kanye, but I don't remember for sure.
I mean, he still said questionable things.
No, but I'm just saying, I think this was before he went full fucking wacko.
No, for sure, but... I definitely had stuff to work with.
No, yeah, I think it was before that. I don't actually remember when the edit was made. I just remember it got recommended to me like a few months ago.
Remember when he compared himself to Patrick Bateman?
Nope.
Well, he did that.
Kind of missing the point of the movie, though.
Yeah.
You're willingly comparing yourself to Patrick Bateman. Ugh. Come on, that was a headshot.
That was getting heavy.
Hey! Yo, what's up? Day ain't your day, pancakes. Just happened to me. I've only dropped 167 frames for the on the network. Nice try, bitch. Dennis, What are your thoughts on Wallace Shawn as Rex from the Toy Story movies?
Good performance.
Yeah.
The Toy Story had, like, perfect casting.
Yeah. Until Tim Allen turned out to be an idiot. Really sucks, because I like Tim Allen's voice.
Yeah, I actually don't really know what Pixar was thinking when they wanted to Billy Crystal for that role first.
That's really? That he was an option?
Yeah, Billy Crystal turned it down, and he claims it's the biggest regret of his career. He was, like, trying endlessly, please, Pixar, take me for a movie.
And that is that why he was in Monsters, Inc.? Mike Wazowski is the perfect character for perfect animated character. There's a College Humor video about,
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, they meet their monsters and they just drew a green Billy Crystal and they're like, it's the most horrifying thing I've ever seen.
I remember someone theorized that Monsters University was an allegory for disability, and it actually really makes sense.
I haven't seen it in a long time, so like I'd have to rewatch it to really consider that.
Like how Mike is just kind of born not scary.
And he learns to accept that.
Yeah.
You ever seen Freak the Mighty? Or not seen it, you ever read it?
Freak the Mighty? No.
It was a book I read in, like, elementary school. It was very... I remember it being very good. It's about, like, a big... He's not stupid. Like, he's not, like, the stereotypical, like, brute who's stupid. He's, like, not smart, but he's, you know, he's not... He's an average guy, but he's, like, big and strong, and people are, like... intimidated by him, but he's not a bully. He just is big, so people are naturally intimidated by him. And he and this very scrawny, tiny nerd kid become good friends. And he puts the tiny kid on his shoulders, and then they, like, walk around like that, and they call themselves Freak the Mighty when they're like that. And I don't really remember, like, what they do, like, what the overall plot is, like, what they end up doing, or where the plot resolution is. But I remember it, like, halfway through the story, there's, like, a twist, and it's, like, really sad, because it turns out, because the nerdy kid, I don't remember either of their names, he, like, tells the bigger kid, like, oh, I haven't told you this since we became friends, but I was born with, like, a heart condition where my heart grows too fast for my body to keep up with, and I've had it since I was a kid, and the book ends with him dying at, like, the age of 13. And the bigger kid just, like, learns a lot about life, and he learns a lot from being his friend. And I remember it being a very good book, but, like, reading it in elementary school, it, like, made me confront mortality, and I was like, oh, fuck. I think I had already, like, thought about death before that, but, like, it was, like, just a reinforcement of it. Like, oh, fuck. I got very sad reading that book, but it was good.
I think the only other times I really had to confront that, like, at a very early age were, Grandpa's death and, believe it or not, Muppet Christmas Carol.
Hmm. Yeah, that movie's sad. I saw Saving Private Ryan when I was, like, 12, and that movie made me very sad. Saving Private Ryan's a very good movie.
I gotta watch it again.
Tom Hanks is awesome in it, and so is Matt Damon. I'm so bad at this game. That was Matt Damon, right?
Was it?
I'm pretty sure he was in it.
Saving.
I'm pretty sure he played Private. Yes. Yeah, he played Private Ryan. I thought so, but I wasn't 100% sure, and I was like, am I making an ass of myself by saying that? But no, I wasn't. That was him. That's probably one of my favorite Tom Hanks roles. Right up there with Barnacle Portal. And the Doobie Brothers get vasectomies.
Huh?
What, you haven't seen those?
No.
There's some classic Tom Hanks movies. Captain Pahinus.
Oh yeah.
This man has one wet foot.
Hog.
No, it was bag. With the tagline, what if you had a bag? Captain Pahinus. Barnacle Portal. He was in that one movie just called Tom Hanks where he played the little cowboy puppet.
Yeah. And Tom Hanks 3 was really good.
Yeah. I kinda watched that video again. For anyone who doesn't know what I'm referencing, Neil Cicerega has this series of videos he does called The Complete Guide to Blank. And basically he just goes over a comprehensive guide of certain things. But he like mispronounces all the names. So for example, there's one that's like Guide to the Lord of the Rings, and it's like our main and he always talks in this like breathy, whispery voice. He's like, our main character, Fingo Froggins, like, and they just get weirder and weirder as there's like what's his name? Gimli, son of Gloin. It's like, and Grimbo, son of Groin. And shit like that, and there's one where it's just the guide
they're
to every-
They're taking the homies to laser tag!
Yeah, they're taking the homies to laser tag! There's a whole video dedicated to Tom Hanks movies and shows that he was in. And and all of the posters are edited. Like, he has movie posters for them, and they're actually photoshopped to say the fucked up title. And he adds, like, his own tagline, and the actors' names are screwed up. Like, Barnacle Portal is what he called Bachelor Party. I think Saving Private Ryan was solving a pirate's riddle.
What about the Doobie Brothers?
It was the Boner Boys Get Vasectomies is the one I was thinking of, not the Doobie Brothers. It was the Boner Brothers. The Boner Boys?
But what was the fucking original movie?
The Boner Boys Get Vasectomies, let me see. No, looking that up just gives me stuff about getting erectile dysfunction.
Try with quotes.
Hang on. You know what, fuck it, let's just watch this video on stream, because it's really good. It's a very good video. Let me turn on the display capture.
Hello, Hank's Master here.
Here, let me screen share it so Dennis can watch it with me. This fucking video is so good.
Hank's Master here. Hello, Hank's Master here. Moderator of the Tom Hanks fan forums, General Tom Hanks chat sub forum. I'd like to address.
I'm not gonna get my VOD muted. It's not copyrighted audio.
Ace Ventura fan fans.
Man Hanks from his
what do you mean get my VOD muted?
Pumpkins on Mad TV. Mr. Hanks.
I'm, like
has
I'm
had
playing
a
copyrighted music.
Far
it's just
what
a video
so
about
for
him.
Your own education, I urge you to rent every title I'm about to list. You'll
I hate that picture.
Later. Tom Hanks got his start on the hit sitcom The Booty Brothers with Peegle Scalia, which Peegle led to a breakout starring role in Ron Howler's Splanch with Terry Hamper, followed by comedies such as Barnacle Portal, This Man Has One Wet Foot, and The Pony Pimp, and dramas such as Nomming on Cotton with Chappie Gleek Squad, Everybody Dance Now, and crime films like Pregnant with Dan Ass. Then one of his most famous roles, Bag, which marked the Tom Hanks evolution from boy to to Man. Then there was Lunch Pipe with Sally Fear. Then Blogs, Tuber and Hoonis. Joe Verm's Big Volleyball with Mug Ryland. The Boner Boys Get Vasectomies. The Lord of the Rings with Gila Dermis and Matongo. Sadness in the Saddle again with Mo Rogan. Phil Donahue with Gonzo Washing Up Liquid. Furry Grunt, Sweet 16. Pig Stars Tom Hanks, where he plays a little Tom Hanks puppet. You That Thing Do, solving a
I love that one because he didn't even, he just Tom rearranged Hanks the words.
Puppet. You That Thing Do, solving a pirate's riddle. You'll Get Soil, his final film with Eggs Ringo. Tom Hanks 2, Puppet Wife. The Queen's Milk. Casual Hanks. He also produced 2001's dark reboot of The Booty Brothers for HBO Kids. Then he was in Rodeo Potion. Eat My Ass, Bitch, with Leonardo DiCaprio.
Eat My
the
Ass,
Lady
Bitch.
Kissers. The Time Burger. The Pope's Train, again playing a Tom Hanks puppet. The DVD Case, Cheeky Williams Worms, Apples and Dapples, Tom Hanks 3, Resurrection, Leggy Clown, An Extremely Big Loud Baby, Clam Ambush, Captain Penis, Saving My Bacon, with Emma Thong Song, A Smidge of Spice, The King of the Hobgoblins, Soily, the movie where Tom Hanks can fly. Big Bobo, The Sparkle with Emma Whalesong. And The Probst with Mermel Spep. And that's just the beginning. Tom Hanks has thousands of films not known to the general public, which we discuss on the Advanced Tom Hanks subforum. You've got a long way to go before you gain access, newbies, so turn on your TV and begin your Hank off. Good luck.
Let's watch the one of about Lord of the Rings.
Greetings, fellow travelers. Big Ring Lover here. Today I'm going to guide you through the epic fantasy known as J.R.P.G. Torkelson's Lord of the Rings trilogy, directed by Tito Jackson. Let's go. Book 1, The Friendship of the Rim, introduced us to the world of Google Earth, beginning with the sewer, home of the hobos, a race of little boys, including Fraggle Batches, who is our hero, as well Fraggle as his Batches. Uncle Bingo Beckham, his cousins Maggie and Pissman, and his servant Sam's Club Gun Jeans. It was then that Garfield the Great, a magical old man, arrived and gave Frito the bad ring, which could only be destroyed by throwing it in a volcano. The ring was also sought by the dark wizard Starman, who's under the control of Simon, an eye of great evil. So Faygo and the other Haddocks set off on their quest, pursued by the grim Ringling brothers. They escaped to the town of Beeve, where they met a mysterious man named Sliders. With him, they traveled to the realm of
Riverdale.
You know,
Riverdale, fuck it. We're just gonna watch the videos cause for the rest of the stream. There's only like 10 minutes left before
and
I gotta go,
father,
so.
Lord Ephraim. There, Grandfunk returned, along with the noble man, Boner Car, and an elk named Legalized Greenleaf, and a smurf named Gumball, son of Groin. We also learned Slimer's secret name, Air.
I like Neil's little channel icon. It's just Garfield giving a thumbs up.
Together, they formed the Brotherhood of the Wolf, sworn to protect Fievel as he went west. They soon came to the mines of Moneyball, where Gummo the Dilf discovered that his
Gummo
family
the Dilf.
Had been killed by the vicious Uggs, who would soon attack our heroes. Gundam the Good became locked in battle with the beastly Red Bull and sacrificed himself to let his friends escape. They pressed on to the forest realm of Los Lobos, where they met Glockenspiel, who kissed Floby on top of his head. Soon tensions grew as Beeramid tried to take the ring from Finkel, but luckily he was shot by the Orchid Commander Lovitz, whose head got cut off. Flicka and his faithful sand whale were separated from the others, but they continued onwards towards the dark realm of Mordecai. Later, in Book 2, the two princes, they encountered the vile Sneaker and his twin brother Colin, who lived underwater. Meanwhile, Meme Base and Pigeon were captured by the Oinks. Legginess realized
they're taking the homeboys to laser tag.
But in fact, they escaped and found themselves in Gulf Forest, where they met Mr. Tree, who carried them to safety. Meanwhile, the fellows were reunited with Gambit the White, who is now an angel. He summoned Carfax, who was a horse. They all traveled to the kingdom of Rubdown, where they met Captain Titanic, who was hypnotized by his butler, Earthworm Jim, a spy working for Silly String. They banished him and prepared for the Battle of Holmes Depot. They met the king's niece, Eowyn, who fell in love with Aragorn, but his heart belonged to Airwolf. Too bad. Meanwhile, Bunny Man's brother, Funny Man, captured Fuego and his companions, and then let them go. Against all odds, the army of Rigatoni defeated the cops, taking us to Book 3, The Return to Innocence. Gandhi, Lycos, Gizmo, and King Lion King were reunited with Manny and Petty, and discovered that the Dark Wizard SodaStream had died. Gangnam whisked Pepe to the castle of Mario Tennis, met Lord Disney Store, Steward of Groban, who took the young Hepcat as a gift. Meanwhile, as Favreau approached Muldoon, Slam Jam began to grow suspicious of Grodom, who soon led them into the web of Shebangs, a tarantula, who tried to eat GoPro, but got stabbed. Meanwhile, Autobahn's father-in-law, Lord Eggnog, gave him a magic sword that proved he was the rightful king of England.
Is that,
Then he ventured into a haunted cave and
recruited plays a MIDI of the boys are back in town right here.
Down, and his dad, Lord Dinosaur, lost his mind and caught on fire. Then there was much war, horses, AOL defeated the worst witch,
the boys are back in town,
and elephants. Finally, as Ponyo arrived at the precipice of Big Thunder
Was Hugo
Mountain,
weaving the one
ring's
guy?
Great power seduced his finger, but Gherkin attacked him and ate the finger. With the ring, he fell into the lava, uttering one last time his signature phrase.
I'm precious.
With the purity ring destroyed, Snow Cone crumbled, and the Yeerk armies were defeated. Glamrock summoned the Philadelphia Eagles to rescue Furtado and Slumdog, bringing us to Book 4, Epilogue. Anakin was crowned the king of town and married Enya. The Hubcaps returned to their home, but Fucko decided that this life was not for him. And so he joined his uncle Binya Binya on a cruise ship with Game Shark the White. He kissed Snapfish on top of the head and sailed away into the Caribbean. Well, that's the story of JTT Culkin's King of the Ring. And remember, if you should ever wish to...
I got time for one more quick video before I go. And I want to introduce everyone to one of my favorite YTPs. All time. I have a playlist just called Important YTPs, which is just where I put ones that I find funny or culturally important, like ones that were, like, even if they're not good anymore, ones that were, like, really popular back in the day. And we're gonna watch one by Pedge that I mentioned earlier. It's just called P. I love that there's just a USB connect sound in this for some reason. We're not watching Pizza Time. One, because it's disgusting, and two, because I'll get banned from Twitch.
Snoopy! have a like a dark
whoops,
horse?
I opened Twitch on my other monitor. Make a video like this, but like I don't even
do it with what was it, Gary's people as the basis.
I don't know. I want to do it with something, but like I don't even know how Pedge reads shit like this. Like I can't even imagine how one would edit something like this. Like what Pedge's process was. I wish they were still active on their channel. Or like had a Twitter link or something, because I really just want to message them and be like, how the fuck do you do shit like this? I'm not doing it with pizza time. Here comes the drop. I fucking love that video so much. All right, I gotta go, gamers. But
thank you. What are we raiding?
We're gonna raid Joe Fudge. He's streaming right now. How long is this? It's like 3 minutes. Yeah, he's streaming right now. So yeah, he's playing Totally Accurate Battle Simulators. So yeah, everyone have a good night. I might be streaming tomorrow because I'm off work, but I also have some stuff planned. So I guess we'll see. Goodbye.
I'm not off work.